Wasteland by T.S.ELIOT. First, the burial of the dead. April is the cruelest month, breeding lilacs out of the dead land, mixing memory and desire, stirring spring rain. Winter kept us warm, covering earth in forgetful snow, feeding a little life with dried tubers. Summer surprised us, coming over the Stamberger say with a shower of rain. We stopped in the colonnade and went on in sunlight into the hoof and drank coffee and talked for an hour. Bin gar keine Russin, Stammhaus Litauen, heute Deutsch. And when we were children, staying at the Archduke's, my cousins, he took me out on a sled and I was frightened. He said, Marie, Marie, hold on tight. And down we went. In the mountains, there you feel free. I read much of the night and go south in the winter. What are the roots that clutch? What branches grow out of this stony rubbish? Son of man, you cannot say or guess, for you know only a heap of broken images where the sun beats and the dead tree gives no shelter, the cricket no relief, and the dry stone no sound of water only. And your hair wet, I could not speak, and my eyes failed. I was neither living nor dead, and I knew nothing, looking into the earth of light. The silence, Oiden l'air das mer. Madame Sosostris, famous clairvoyante, had a bad cold. Nevertheless, is known to be the wisest woman in Europe. With a wicked pack of cards, here, said she, is your card. The drawn Venetian sailor, those are pearls that wear his eyes. Look, here is Belladonna, the lady of the rocks, the lady of situations. Here is the man with three staffs, and here the wheel, and here is the only height merchant. And this card, which is blank, is something he carries on his back, which I am forbidden to see. I do not find the hanged man. Fear death by water. I see crowd of people walking round in a ring. Thank you. If you see dear Mrs. Equiton, tell her I bring the horoscope myself. One must be so careful these days. A real city under the brown fog of a winter town. A crowd flowed over London Bridge. So many. I had not thought that has undone so many. Sighs, short and infrequent, were exhaled, and each man fixed his eyes before his feet, flowed up the pier and down King William Street, to where St. Mary Woolnoth kept the hours, with a dead sound of the final stroke of nine. There I saw one I knew, and stopped him, crying, Stetson, you who were with me in the ships at Mailin, that corpse you planted last year in your garden, has it begun to sprout? Will it bloom this year? Or has the sudden frost disturbed its bed? Oh, keep the dog for hands, that's friend to man, or with his nails he'll dig it up again. You, he nose, stirred by the air that freshened from the window, disenchanted and fluttered in the prolonged candle flames, flung her smoke into the lacrimonia, stirring the pattern on the coffered ceiling, huge chipboard fed with copper, bar green and orange, framed by the colored stone, in which satellite a carved dolphin swam. Above the antique mantel was displayed a stuffy window, came upon the sylvan scene, the change of filmer by the barbarous king, so rarely forced. Yet there the nightingale filled all the desert with inviolable voice, and still she cried, and still the world pierces, chug, chug, to dear the hearse. And the other withered stumps of time were told upon the walls, staring forms, leaned out, leaning, hushing, the room closed. Footsteps shuffled on the stair, under the firelight, under the brush, her hair spread out in fiery points, glowed in the words that would be savagely still. My nerves are bad tonight, yes, bad. Stay with me. Speak to me. Why do you never speak? Speak. What are you thinking of? What thinking? What? I never know what are you thinking. Think. I think we are in Ratsali, where the dead man lost her bones. What is that noise? The wind under the door. What is the noise now? What is the wind doing? Nothing again, nothing. Do you know nothing? Do you see nothing? Do you remember nothing? I remember. Those are pearls that wear his eyes. Are you alive or not? Is there nothing in your head? But, oh, 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 that Shakespearean wreck is so elegant, so intelligent. What shall I do now? What shall I do? I shall rush out as I am on the street with my hair down. So what shall we do tomorrow? What shall we ever do? The hot water at 10, and if it rains, a closed car at 4, and we shall play a game of chess, pressing little sighs and waiting for a knock upon the door. When Lil's husband got demobbed, I said, I didn't mince my words. I said to her myself, hurry up, please, it's time. Now Albert's coming back, make yourself a bit smart. He'll want to know what you done with that money we gave you to get yourself some teeth. He did, I was there. You had them all out, Lil. Get a nice set, he said as well. I can bear to look at you, and no more can I, I said, and think of poor Albert. He's been in the army 4 years. He wants a good time, and if you don't give it him, that's harder will, I said. Oh, he's there, she said. Something of that, I said. Then I'll know who to thank, she said. Give me a straight look. Hurry up, please. It's time. If you don't like it, you can get what we should, I said. Others can pick and choose if you can't. But if Harper makes off, it won't be for lack of telling. You ought to be ancient, I said, to look so antique. And we're only 31. I can't help it, she said, pulling a long face. It's them pills I took to bring it off, she said. She's had 5 already, and nearly died of young George. The chemist said it would be alright, but I've never been the same. You are a proper fool, I said. Well, if Albert won't leave you alone, there it is, I said. What you get married for if you don't want children? Hurry up, please, it's time. Well, that Sunday Albert was home. They had a hot game on, and they asked me into dinner to get the beauty of it out. Hurry up, please, it's time. Hurry up, please, it's time. Good night, Bill. Good night, Lou. Good night, May. Good night. Ta-ta. Good night. Good night. Good night, ladies. Good night, sweet ladies. Good night. Sermon. The river's dent is broken. The last fingers of leaf clutch and sink into the wet bank. The wind crosses the brown land unearthed. The nymphs are departed. Sweet Thames run softly till I end my song. The river bears no empty bottles, sandwich papers, silk handkerchiefs, cardboard boxes, cigarette scents, or utter testimony of summer nights. The nymphs are departed, and their friends, the loitering heirs of city directors, departed and left no addresses. By the waters of Lemon, I sat down and wept. Sweet Thames, run softly till I end my song. Sweet Thames, run softly, for I speak no loud or long. But at my back in a cold blast I hear the rattle of the bones, and chuckles spread from ear to ear. A rat crept softly through the vegetation, dragging its slimy belly on the bank, while I was fishing in the tall canal, on a winter evening ground behind the girl's house. Music upon the king, my brother's wreck, and on the king, my father's death before him. White bodies naked on the loathed ground, and bones cast in a little low dry garret, rattled by the rat's foot only, ear to ear. But at my back from time to time I hear the sound of horns and motors which shall bring Sweeney to Miss Porter in the spring. Oh, the moon shone bright on Mrs. Porter and on her daughter. They washed their feet in soda water. Et tu, c'est quoi d'enfant, chantant de la coupole. Tweet, 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 chuck, 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 so rudely forced to roll. A real city under the brown fog of a winter noon. Mr. Eugenides, the Smyrna merchant, unshaved with a pocket full of currants. CIF London, documents at sight, axe meeting the morning French, the luncheon at the Cannon Street Hotel, followed by a weekend at the Metropole. At the Violet Hour, when the highs and peck, arms up from the desk when the human engine waits, like a taxi throbbing waiting. I, Tiresias, deaf blind, throbbing between two lives, old man with wrinkled female breasts, can see.
Il volume della nuova planetary in tutti I negozi intimissimi.
Ieri sera ho avuto una discussione animata con Paul Delaunay prima che lasciassero la festa.
Aveva una relazione con sua moglie?
Prego. Sono un amico di famiglia da 40 anni. Ho fatto da testimone del matrimonio. Sono il padrino di Ludwig.
Allora si rimetta a sedere e risponda alla domanda.
Ieri sera ho avuto una discussione con Paul. È successo altre volte, ma non a proposito di Elena.
Continui, l'ascoltiamo.
Ricordava Ludwig. Paul e Elena facevano di tutto per lei. La mostra, la stampa, era merito loro. Ho detto a Paul che era ora che diventasse più autonoma. Ne volevo parlare anche con Elena. E a quel punto si è arrabbiato.
At the violet hour, the evening hour that streams homeward and brings the sailor home from sea. The typist home at tea time clears her breakfast, lights her stove and lays out food and dance. Out of the window perilously spread, her trying combination touched by the sun's last rays. On the divan or pillow, at night or bed, stockings, slippers, chemicals and stays. I, Tiresias, old man with wrinkled arcs, perceived the sun and foretold the rest. I too await a expected guest. He, the young man carbuncular, arrives, a small house agent's clerk with one bold stare. One of the law of home assurance sits as a silk hat on a breathful millionaire. The time is now propitious, as he guesses. The meal is ended, she is bored and tired. He endeavors to engage her in caresses, which still are unreproved if undesired. Flushed and decided, he assaults at once. Exploring hands encounter no defense. His vanity requires no response, and makes a welcome of indifference. And I, Tiresias, have for suffered all, enacted on this same divan or bed. I, who have sat by Thebes below the wall, and walk among the lowest of the dead. Pistols one final patronizing kiss, and gropes his way, finding the stairs unlit. She turns and looks a moment in the glass, hardly aware of her departed lover. Her brain allows one half-formed thought to pass. Well, now that's done, and I'm glad it's over. One lovely woman stops to fall in and paces about her room again, alone. She smooths her hair with automatic hand and puts a record on the gramophone. This music ripped by me upon the waters and along the Strang, up Queen Victoria Street. Oh, city, city. I can sometimes hear, beside a public bar in Lower Thames Street, the pleasant whining of a mandoline, and the clatter on the charter from within, where fishmen lounge at noon, where the walls of Magnus Martyr hold inexplicable splendor of Ionian white and gold. The river sweats oil and tar, the barges drift with a turning tide, red sails wide to leeward swing on the heavy spar. The barges wash drifting logs down Greenwich Ridge past the Isle of Dogs. Wayalala leya, walala leyalala. Elizabeth and Leicester, breathing hoarse, the stand was formed, a gilded shell. Red and gold, the brisk swell rippled both shores. Southwest wind carried downstream the peal of bells, white towers. Vayalala leya, walala leyalala. Drums and dusty grease, Highbury born, Richmond and Kew undid me. By Richmond harassed my knees, supine on the floor of a narrow canoe. My feet are at Morgate and my hearth under my feet. After the event, he wept. He promised a new start. I made no comment. What should I resent? death by what? Phlebas, the Phoenician, a fortnight dead, forgot the cry of gods and the deep sea swell and the profit and loss. A current undersea picked his bone in whispers. As he rose and fell, he passed the stages of his ancient youth, entering the whirlpool. Gentile or Jew, or you who turned the wheel and looked windward, consider Phlebas, who was once handsome and tall as you.
And beat their wings and crawled head downward down a blackness.
upside down in air where flowers, tolling reminiscent bells that kept the hours, and voices singing out of tempting cisterns and exhausted wells. In this decayed hall among the mountains, in the faint moonlight, the grass is singing over the tumbled graves, about the chapel. There is the empty chapel, only the wind's home. It has no windows, and the door swings. Dry bones can harm no one. Only a cock stood on the roof tree. Cockerico, cockerico, in a flash of light. Then a damp gust, bringing rain. Ganga was sunken, and the limp leaves waited for rain, while the black clouds gathered far distant over Himavant. The jungle crouched, humped in silence. Then spoke the thunder. Ta, 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 what have we given? My friend, blood shaking my heart. The hopeful daring of a moment's surrender, which an age of prudence can never attract. By these and these only we have existed, which is not to be found in our obituaries, or in memories draped by the beneficent spider, or under seals broken by the lean solicitor in our empty rooms. Da, die at fun. I have heard the key turn in the door once and turn once only. We think of the key, each in his prison, thinking of the key, each confirms a prison. Only at nightfall, ethereal rumors revive for a moment a broken Coriolanus. Da, da mayat. The bot responded gaily to the hand expert with Ceylon ore. The sea was calm, your heart will have responded gaily when invited, beating obedient to controlling hands. I sat upon the shore, fishing, with a hurried plane behind me. Shall I at least set my lens in order? London Bridge is falling down, falling down, falling down. Poesia scusa nel fuoco che gli affina. Quando fia muti keliton, oh swallow, swallow. Le prince d'Aquitaine à la tour abolie. These fragments I have shored against my ruins. Why, then he'll feed you. Hieronymus mad again. Dayatvam, Damyata, Shanti, Shanti.